1,000 million people in Asia. And tonight, I bring to you the best part of its treasures.
He came in dressed with this big, huge raincoat and just the boot. That's all you saw, black.
Smile was a thrilling performance. But this second new song was Sudirman's masterstroke.
They got, I think the audience and the judges got it straight away that this was a song just for this occasion. 1,000 million smiles, I bring to you across the miles. Always win. 1,000 million smiles, I bring to you across the miles. In my land of sunshine, or in your land of snow, makes no difference where you are.
So I think the nature of our Asian smiling and welcoming you and making our foreign guests feel so at ease is a trademark.
If you want to talk about singing, there are other people who will sing a lot better. And if you want to talk about dancing, there are a lot of people who dance a lot better. But if you want to talk about a package, then I don't think anyone has a package like Sudir.
Got halfway through the song and there's a dance section. And it's about 15 seconds of very hard dancing.
Once he started taking off his raincoat to reveal his, you know what he wore inside, the crowd went wild.
When you do a dance section that hard, you cannot come back from it singing. The moment he finishes, he goes straight on a high note, and it's impossible.
After Sudir did his 1,000 million smiles, we were very confident that he would win.
Once Sudirman performed, well, I didn't have to wait for the judges to know that I thought he would win.
But Sudirman hadn't won yet. The singer from the Philippines, Kula Desma, wowed the judges too. She was clearly a serious rival.
I thought that my song was a very powerful song as well. But I must say that Sudirman had a beautiful song. You know, it was a well-written song.
And now, Mr. Jameson, who will get the Best Performance of the Evening Award?
Ladies and gentlemen, we do have a clear winner.
Da-da-da-da! The winner is...
The award goes to Sudirman.
I was very, very happy. And all of us were jumping up and down for joy, you know?
I think really he deserved it because he just gave a great performance.
See his face. You're not going to find anything more natural than that. A joy of such a relief.
And this was the highest point in his career. He's worked so hard to achieve this.
Just 3 years later, it would all be over. With cruel speed, a mortal illness would bring Sudirman's career to an end. After his spectacular win in London, Sudirman returned to Malaysia in triumph. He was on a high and was showered with offers of business deals and even summoned to meet the Prime Minister, Dr. Mahathir Mohamad. In 1989, he performed in Malaysia's National Stadium at the climax of the Southeast Asian Games. Energized by his success in London, Sudirman now made some challenging demands on his collaborators.
Sudirman had specially ordered an extra long cape.
100-meter cape. 200 athletes for the closing ceremony from different countries. You had to persuade all these athletes who are coming for the closing ceremony, you're finishing this run, I want them to carry my cape when I walk in with my grand entrance. That alone was a logistical nightmare. Couple that with a heavy thunderstorm, Stadium Merdeka is full. Prime Minister is in attendance. Somehow or other, he said, please, Lada, we have to perform, we have to perform. And perform he did.
We were leading him. Again, the two of us were in front of him, leading him with our Malaysian flags in hand. We went into the centre of the field where there was a platform, and then we stood there, and he continued to walk right up to that platform, and he finished the song there.
For a while, in the early 1990s, Sudirman seemed to be everywhere, either as a performer or an image on a new range of branded commodities. But as his career flourished, Sudirman's colleagues and friends began to notice that he was often drained. His old, unquenchable energies seemed to be flagging.
I used to go into his room in the office and catch him. He wouldn't even know I was there. He was like so engrossed in, like that. Then there were times he would just like that. So I knew something was not right.
So there was me, even Jenny Chin and Darani, the manager, the backup singers, everything was in the studio. That day was weird because Sudirman, as you know, is a guy who can remember everything, even that 20 pages of script he can remember. On that day, he can't even remember his lyrics.
These unprecedented lapses of memory were troubling enough. And Sudirman had become obsessed with his own mortality, as if he knew something that his friends and colleagues did not.
He just said he just feel, but he don't know when, but he believe he will die young.
Saya rasa saya nak sakit ni pasal ada orang nak nyanyi saya, dia kata.
All too soon, Sudirman began cancelling shows and withdrawing from public view. He could no longer hide the fact that he was ill.
There would be long periods when he was unable to, he was sick, and there'd be, you know, he's cutting back on his shows, cutting back on the number of performances and engagements.
But Sudirman could not stop performing completely. In July 1991, he travelled to Butterworth in northern Malaysia to give a show. It would turn out to be his very last. As he was singing, Sudirman collapsed and was rushed into hospital. All Malaysia was stunned. Sudirman would never appear in public again.
I heard he had a stroke. Fell down from the staircase.
He wasn't well on and off. But we didn't think it was that serious until he collapsed.
Sudirman was very sick, but no one had any idea about the nature of his illness.
All I knew was that it was quite serious.
It was something that was also well kept away from everybody else. I didn't know why.
Sudirman's family imposed a news blackout. His fans became increasingly desperate to know what was wrong with their hero.
Minat tanya peminat dekat office hotline, panggilan tak berhenti-berhenti tanyakan tentang Sudir, sakit apa, di mana, apa dah jadi.
Inevitably, rumours quickly began spreading. Some said Sudirman could be suffering from AIDS, others that he was a victim of a black magic spell.
The sister told me they find a lot of funny things and materials around the house, you know, something like which people normally do for charming someone, is that something that they never saw before, all that. So we do not know, to believe or not to believe, whether that's the cause or maybe medically sick. I really don't know.
Well, my own experience with this illness was that it was lasting a very long time.
Sudirman spent 6 months in the hospital. But his doctors finally acknowledged that his illness, whatever it was, could not be cured, and sent him home to his sister's house in Bangsar, Kuala Lumpur, to spend his last days. Only one faithful friend and admirer was permitted a few last hours with the dying star. Once called the singing dynamo, but now a frail shadow of the performer who had once captivated all Asia.
Kan tengok dia, kawan tu meraung tau. Kata Sudir, kata, kenapa lah Sudir jadi macam ni? Kata, siapa yang buat Sudir macam ni? Dia tak boleh cakap, tapi masa Yang paling Kak Bang sedih tu bila Kak Bang peluk dia, cium dia, air mata dia meleleh tau, keras. Air mata dia meleleh, bergenang air mata dia tau. Maknanya dia tahu kita, cuma dia tak boleh bercakap kan. Ha, dia tahu, dia dengar suara kan.
We actually didn't know how ill he was because then the time we were told it was kind of like he is, you know, dying, you know.
On the 22nd of February 1992, just before dawn, Sudirman died at his sister's house.
When I saw the crowd, I said, yes, this is it, he has gone. I went upstairs where he was laid. I just pulled down the closet which was closing him, and I said, it's true, he's gone, and I feel that.
Sudirman was just 37. The official cause of death was pneumonia. Sudirman Arshad was buried near his parents in Temelo, his birthplace. This had been his last wish. Even today, Sudirman is universally mourned, a great performing artist whose talent was extinguished all too soon.
Walaupun dia orang tuduh dia macam AIDS lah, apalah benda kan, pada Kak Bang dia memang seorang yang manusia yang dipinjamkan oleh Tuhan.
He was, I think, the only all-round entertainer that Malaysia had. So far, there hasn't been anyone who could replace him.
For many of his closest friends, Sudirman's short life was a blessed one. Its pattern written in the stars.
This is your part, Sudirman. You will become Asia's best. You will get your heart's content, and you know, you will leave the world early as well. You didn't have to do anything more. This is written for you. This is your script, your life script.
On one end of the spectrum, he is an ordinary person like you and I, going about his daily life, quiet, humble, simple even. But put him on the world stage and he transforms into this amazing entertainer, this superstar of a man, just 5 feet, 1 inches in height, but larger than life on stage. And loved, so loved by everybody.
Sama-sama.